Terry, we don't know his name or what he was doing here with LPD, but we do know he was helping, giving them tips for the investigation, and he's in custody for charges not related to Zoe's case. And we just got word that the chief of police will be speaking with us soon more about this investigation. And just a little while ago, I saw the Emmy's truck parked near the house. They're searching here at 70th and Sherman. From what we know, police have been following tips all week, one being a backyard here in this neighborhood on 70th and Sherman, again, really close to Lowry Field. The last time they saw Zoe's phone, where it was pinged, police got a search warrant for the house here at Sherman to search the entire home for blood, trace evidence, and human remains. This is where they found a bone last week, and we're still waiting to hear if it's a human bone or not. Tomorrow marks 5 years since Zoe vanished without a trace. She was 18 years old when she went missing in 2013. Police looking for her ever since. Her phone was last pinged, like I mentioned, near Lowry Field, which is just about a mile from here, and her car was being driven by someone else in the days after she vanished. Her car was later found abandoned at a Central Lubbock apartment complex. And now bringing you back to 2018, on Wednesday, Lubbock police has mounted patrol near I-27 and 66th Street, all three locations in the same area. And we're still working to find out if they found anything in their searches. And again, the chief of police says that he's going to be speaking with us soon. So make sure you keep up with us on our Facebook and our app, Everything Lubbock. We're going to stream everything live. We're going to bring you all the updates directly to your phone. Reporting for KOBK News, I'm Madi Salazar.
All right, Madi, thank you so much. We'll look to hear from you in a bit. Well, we brought you the story of a family asking for help after their 8-year-old son's expensive medication was stolen off their front porch. All of it was caught on camera. Now, today, the medication was found and returned to the Nicholson family after police arrested the woman responsible. Our Courtney Fromm tells us what this means to the family.
Thank you for finding the muffin. The police.
I don't know. I'm just thinking, yes, Virginia, there is a Santa Claus. We get our Christmas present early.
$3,000 of relief after Lubbock police returned the medication taken by this woman in broad daylight off their front porch over a month ago.
And we can ship it back to the manufacturer, and they'll reimburse our account, so we'll be all even and square. It'll be great.
Lubbock police say 33-year-old Virginia Amaya was arrested for parole violation and burglary of habitation unrelated to this medication theft case.
Police called Jeremy today and said that they had arrested our thief. All four injections are still in there. They just opened it and tossed it to the side. I just never would have believed that we would see it again. I'm so excited.
The Nicholson family says they're just thrilled that Henry's medication has been returned.
I'm appreciative that she told them where it was, and she could have just not said anything, and I just hope that she can turn things around and make better choices. You ready for a shot?
Nope.
Courtney Fromm, KLBK News.
All right, thank you, Courtney. An update on the deadly crash from early this morning. A rollover claimed the life of 20-year-old Jericho Garcia. This wreck happened just before 2:30 this morning, where police and EMS responded to the accident near Frankfort and the West Loop. We're told that Garcia died at the scene. That West Loop and Frontage Road between Frankfort and 12th Street is back open. And a former teacher that admitted to a sexual relationship with a 17-year-old was sentenced today in federal court. Dustin Leonard was sentenced to 10 years in prison. He also has 10 years of supervised release and must register as a sex offender for the next 25 years after he gets out. 28-year-old Dustin Leonard pleaded guilty on Monday to one count of enticement of a minor. Court records show in July of 2016, Leonard was hired by Slayton High School as a teacher and a coach. Now, at first, Leonard denied the allegations to the principal, but later, the 17-year-old and Leonard admitted to a consensual sexual relationship that began back in January. Let's check back in with our Heidi Wagner right now. Heidi, what can we expect for the weekend?
It is going to be a lot cooler as you walk out the door tonight and throughout this weekend, so make sure to grab those jackets. You see the cloud cover increasing. That's because we do have a system that is pushing into the region. It's just not bringing us any rain, just those cooler conditions. We've now dropped to 46 in Lubbock, 50 in Midland, 46 in Amarillo, 43 in the San Angelo regions, and of course, looking at 52 in Dallas. For tomorrow, dry, sunny conditions, but cloud cover will increase a little. And then we do see those temperatures continue to drop. We'll move from 51 for the high tomorrow to 45 on your Sunday. So you definitely want to bundle up and be prepared for those freezing temperatures to return. Rain chances also returning by Wednesday of next week, but it's short-lived and it looks like a drier holiday on the way. 7-day forecast shows those cooler conditions, freezing temperatures Sunday morning, and then after that, a warming trend. friend into your Thanksgiving holiday.
All right. Thanks so much, Heidi. We appreciate that. Well, there's just 3 days left to participate in the Easiest Pie campaign. It's so easy. All you have to do is head out to any United Market Street or Amigos, donate $5 to Meals on Wheels, and in return, you'll receive a coupon for a free Mrs. Smith's pie. All of that just in time for Thanksgiving. And it's always nice to see and hear good news. Takesha Brown sent us a post from Facebook that she had written. She had her two little boys with her at Walmart one morning, and the boys spotted a police car and got really excited because they like police and fire vehicles. Well, the officer saw their excitement, came over to talk to the boys about school, and then went back to his vehicle, and he brought each of the boys a stuffed animal. Takesha says her kids have no idea about police brutality in those stories, and that they will hear about it one day, but she said they will also know that not all cops are bad. Her two boys look at Lubbock Police Officer Walton as their hero, and Mrs. Brown is so thankful that he took the time to sit down and visit with them.
And of course, we are so incredibly excited to announce that John and Emily Hansen have had another baby boy. It's so exciting. He was born this afternoon around 5:59 p.m., weighed 9 pounds, 6 ounces. Adorable little nugget to add to the clan. It is very exciting news, and of course, a long time coming. I feel like 9 months for every mom. Everybody's like, oh, it's always 9 months, but I feel like,
it's a long time.
It's a long time. It's a long wait, so we're so excited that he has arrived.
Yes, just baby and mom are doing perfectly well.
That's right. It's very exciting.
Thrilled for them. Congratulations to the whole family. All right, don't go anywhere. Still to come, the high school football playoffs kicked off this week. Our Paul Tubbs has all the highlights just ahead in your KLBK Friday Night Blitz. Welcome back. We are going to bring you some breaking news right now. We're going to go ahead and send it back to our Mati Salazar, who is live from 70th and Sherman with our police chief, Greg Stevens. Mati, what have they got to say?
On 70th Street for several days now. You all are already aware it's part of the Zoe Campos investigation. Earlier in this investigation, as we've been here on 70th Street, we'd uncovered a bone. I'm going to say that bone that we uncovered earlier was confirmed to not be human, and so this investigation has taken a number of different directions. We've been out here again for some time, proceeding with that investigation. You know that we checked a field in another at 66 in the interstate. We've done some other processes in the investigation. Throughout today, we were able to develop more information and began to dig in a different part of the yard. And earlier this evening, we did uncover what are human remains in this backyard on 70th Street. I obviously at this point cannot confirm who those remains are. I will say that, of course, this is part of the Zoe Campos investigation. But I want to emphasize and reiterate what we've uncovered. We cannot identify those remains as Zoe Campos. A lot of work will have to be done through the medical examiner's office and some forensic work to determine who those remains belong to. Nonetheless, we were digging in a location where we believe Zoe may have ultimately been buried. So I'll leave it at that. We do have a suspect. We are working towards procuring a warrant for murder. There's still a lot of work to be done. Still a large crime scene to process. That'll carry on through the weekend and into next week. I don't have a lot more information than that right now to put out. I'll try to answer some very quick questions that you might have. We'll look towards holding a full press conference Monday, Tuesday, at some point into the week after our detectives have been able to process all that they've found and all the work that they've done, confer with the medical examiner's office, and after they've been able to excavate this entire site and recover all the remains that are there. We do believe that there is an entire human body that has been buried in the backyard where we've uncovered that. So with that, I'll try to answer what questions I can that you have right now. Again, please understand it's going to be very limited, but I'll try my best to answer what I can for you.
Is the suspect currently in custody right now?
The person that we're looking at right now is in custody for an unrelated matter that has nothing to do with the Zoe Campos investigation. However, it is someone that we've looked at previously. As this long investigation has taken place, it's led in a number of directions. As you guys all know, we've searched several locations. We've talked to a number of different people. In the last couple of weeks, we've developed more information. Our detectives have painstakingly looked over this case from so many different angles, and we've been able to develop the information to lead us to where we are right now. I don't really like the term cold case. We have open investigations that we continue to work on and review with a new detective and look at new information, but also review old information so that we can try to come to this resolution, even with a case that's 5 years old. And as you guys all realize, I think it is tomorrow that is the 5-year anniversary since Zoe went missing. Well, we do, but I can't put that out right now. Again, they are only a suspect. However, we are working on getting a warrant, and once that's done, that would change, and we would be able to, at that point, put out that name. But I can't do that right now.
Will the investigation focus just in this backyard or also the field at 66?
So we're not done yet. I can't say that we're excluding that field. Again, a lot of information that we've been through, but right now, obviously, we dug once in the backyard, moved to another location. Investigations like this are ongoing processes. You look at a lot of information. So even though we found human remains, everything tends to lead you to believe this is Zoe, but we have to confirm that. So and we'll continue to look in locations for other types of evidence, which we've already done this evening, and we'll continue to do those things. So I can't say that this is the only location or that even 66 will be the only locations. We'll continue to do this investigation until it is absolutely complete, as we've done over the last 5 years.
The inmate who was brought in today, how does he have information that helped investigators? What was he doing today?
I can't say. I really can't go into that right now, other than you guys are all aware that we did have an inmate, someone who is in custody, that we brought out, and that obviously provided part of this investigation. He was involved in the investigation.
Does the suspect currently live at this home?
No, and let me make that point there. So, you know, this home has changed ownership over the years. In the last 5 years, changed tenants. It's a rent house, and the tenants that live there now have been through an ordeal. The owners of the property, it's been an ordeal for those folks. It's been an up and down roller coaster, and I can't imagine what that's like for all of those folks, the residents, the owners. We absolutely appreciate the cooperation of the residents as well as the owners, having the police come into your property, dig up the yard, go in and out of the property looking for evidence for something that they're not involved in whatsoever. But to answer that question, no, he doesn't live there currently. We're looking at his residence there at a previous time.
And do we know if that body has been moved from somewhere else, or has it been here the whole time?
You know, we don't know that exactly. There's a lot more investigation to do. It doesn't appear so, but we don't know that for sure.
Can you tell us how the suspect has a relationship to Zoe?
I can't at this point. More of that information will come out. Again, we intend to hold a full press conference to have more information. Well, let me get one more. Somebody else started too. I couldn't name for you all the investigators involved that took a lead role. I think some of them probably retired, you know, over the last couple of years, just and not obviously not because of this, but you know that were seasoned and reached the end of their career and it got assigned to somebody new. But that's good because it brings in a fresh set of eyes. So there, at each investigation, you always have a lead investigator and a backup investigator and all the support investigators. I'm not sure that even if I sat down and put a pin to it, I